everyone. Hi, my name is Nurhana, and today I present you my work on aircraft pitch control checking with lightning mode control. So here is the outline for my presentation today. I will start with some introduction of the work, followed by the design of the controller, the application of the controller, results from the numerical simulation, and lastly conclude my presentation. Basically, the aim of the work is about implementation of robust control, which is, in my study, I choose a sliding mode control on the aircraft dynamics. So what is a SMC, sliding mode control, or SMC? It is a non-linear control with a discontinuous high-speed switching control technique. This control signal forces the system to slide along the sliding surface that represent the desired dynamics of the system. But why SMC? Yes, because the common problem which we face in control of dynamical system is the presence of uncertainties and disturbances when considering a real plant. Since there is always discrepancies between the actual system and the mathematical model, so one of the approach in dealing with model uncertainty is by designing a robust controller, which has become a much interest of current development. The fact that that it is a non-linear controller, it allows the control objective to accomplish beyond the extent linear controllers can ever reach. For example, in tracking the pitch angle and pitch rate at high angle of attack, since it is a non-linear region. In applying the control design, the system is defined as a non-linear system with a fine control, which F is the non-linear function and V is the control matrix. A sliding surface is chosen in which this work, two types of sliding surface are presented, the standard SMC and the integral SMC, with E define the error or the difference between the actual and the demand value. In order to force the trajectory of the system towards the sliding surface in the reaching phase and maintain for a subsequent of time, we can solve the Lyapunov stability criteria, and which this condition, this equation means that the system is stable and controlled such that the state always move toward and reach the sliding surface. With this F dot defined, knowing that the eta should be a positive gain, the dynamics can be substituted back into the equation to get the control action U. As you can see here, the control action U consists of two terms, the equivalent control and the switching control, which we will see later on, that this discontinuous part of the control action causes a chattering to maintain the system on the desired dynamics. So the control design is applied on the longitudinal motion of an aircraft, which presented by the velocity, angle of attack, pitch rate, and the pitch angle as the state vectors, and horizontal stabilator as the control input. In this work, the thrust is assumed to have a constant input. In tracking the pitch dynamics, there are two dynamics as very important, which is the pitch rate and the pitch angle. Because of the theta dot, because of the theta dot is equal to Q, so we take that X to be the theta. Thus, it simplified the control problem into a system model. So here is the numerical simulation between the standard SMC, which compared to the integral SMC result. It is seen that the steady state vector in the integral SMC is eliminated towards the end of the simulation time, whereas the steady state error was presented in the standard SMC at lower eta. However, as eta is increased, the steady state error seems to be gone, but another problem arises with the chattering effect, as you can see of the sinusoidal motion here. This chattering is a high frequency switching as seen in the plotted result. This is because of the previous discontinuous function of the signal function. In order to mitigate this problem, saturation function was used to replace the previous signal function, as can be seen in the next slide. So, in contrary to the signal function, the saturation function showed a better performance for integral SMC as eta is increased. Whereas with the signal function, the best fit show at eta equal to 0.1 for the standard SMC. To have a more contrast view on the results between the standard and integral SMC, the tracking errors were plotted at eta equal to 0.1. We can see clearly that the saturation function eliminates the chattering of the former controller. So in summary, the performance for both standard and integral SMC are compared with variation of the eta as the gain. Also, the difference of the selection for the switching controllers. We have seen how the saturation function reduced the chattering effect greatly, but it is interesting to note that for the standard SMC with the saturation function, at higher eta is seen comparable to the performance of the integral SMC with the saturation function. But SMC is a feasible control option for the proposed aircraft model. However, integral SMC produces a better control performance. With that, I end my presentation for today. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Ms. Mohana. Questions for the presenter? I think you don't have any questions? Okay, if you have any questions, you can ask her. She will be tomorrow also. Okay, thank you very much. So our next presenter.